In this video, I'm going to show you how to use PayPal to accept payments for appointments with Simply Schedule Appointments. We're looking here at the documentation for how to do it. I'm going to walk you through it and show you a few extra things as well. We'll get started by going to the dashboard of our website and under Appointments, go to Settings. Then we'll scroll down to Payments and turn it on there. And then click Edit. And for this one, we're going to choose PayPal. We'll turn it on. And it says right here, PayPal is not yet connected to your PayPal account. So we'll click Edit. And here are some basic settings. The display title is what shows on the form. So this would differentiate from credit card or Stripe or something else. And then there's a description. And this is what the customer sees during checkout. And then we need our PayPal address. This is the one associated with your account. Then we need to send this URL to PayPal. So you'll see that it's been copied. And right here are some instructions on what to do. And that's going to take us to this section of the documentation. But I'm just going to walk you through it. I'm currently logged into PayPal. And in the top right, I'm going to go to my account settings. And then in the left nav, you'll see products and services, and then website payments. And then you'll remember that the URL we copied was for IPN, which is instant payment notifications. We'll click update here on the right, and then choose IPN settings. And right here is where we put in that URL. And we want to receive IPN messages. You can choose do not if you ever want to turn this off, but not actually delete the URL. There. Now that's set up. Now we'll come back over here. And under advanced settings, if you have a developer account at PayPal, you can set up the sandbox. We're not going to do that in this video. So there, all of our settings are set up for basic settings. We'll click Save. So now let's set up an appointment using this. Let's go to Appointment Types first and under Consultation Phone Call. So this is not making an appointment. It is making a type of appointment. And right here is Payments. And you have three options. One is no payment required. That's the default. Then there's optional and required. And here's the difference. If payments are optional, the customer can select to either pay at the time of booking or they can select to pay later. If they select to pay at the time of booking, the appointment will be in pending payment mode only until their payment is completed. If they select to pay later, they can book the appointment without paying at all and the appointment is reserved for them. It's then up to the business to ensure that the customer pays for their appointment. And that happens outside of Simply Schedule Appointments. With required, they cannot even do that. They have to pay before the time slot is required, before the time slot is saved. So I'm going to choose optional, and you can choose a price for an appointment. It must be greater than 50 cents. Note that minimum is different based on currency. So we'll put in $5. Now, for refund and cancellation policy, Simply Schedule Appointments does not handle refunds or cancellations. Nope. Simply Schedule Appointments does not handle refunds. So if somebody canceled their appointment and requested a refund, you would have to go to PayPal or Stripe and refund the money there. So here you can require that they agree. And you would type in what your agreement is. Must be within 48 hours or whatever. I'm going to not require it. And then if you had one, it could be displayed in any of these places. And right now, it applies only to PayPal. If you had Stripe set up, there'd be an option there as well. So now we'll save this. Now let's go make an appointment. We'll say Thursday at noon. And the price is $5. I can choose PayPal or pay later. Pay Later allows them to get through this because it's optional and bring you a check when they meet you for your appointment or whatever. But we're going to choose PayPal. We'll confirm and pay. And this is where we would complete the purchase. I'm not going to do it because I don't want to send $5 to myself. Once the purchase is completed, the appointment is set as booked and is a completed transaction. And that's how you set up PayPal for Simply Schedule appointments. Again, the documentation is here. You can come back and read it more carefully if you need to. There are very short videos on how to do very specific things like put in your IPN, etc. So don't be afraid to go through the docs and watch the video again and get a hold of us if you need support.